The central board, the Reserve Bank of India on Monday decided to transfer Rs 1.73 lakh crore to the government of India. The move today actually comes on the basis of recommendations of the Bimal Jalan committee report. What truly was the Bimal Jalan committee report? In December 2018, RBI constituted a panel on economic capital framework headed by former RBI governor Mr. Bimal Jalan. Key objective of this panel was to review whether RBI has excess reserves that can be transferred to government to meet its investment commitments. After deliberations for 8 months, committee tabled its report on economic capital framework to RBI governor on Friday that was deliberated on Monday by the RBI board. What were the key findings? Committee suggested that the economic capital for RBI should lie within 20 to 24.5% of its balance sheet. RBI, as on June 2019, had economic capital of 23.3% of its balance sheet, making it one of the most resilient central banks. As a result, RBI today decided to transfer surplus net revenue of Rs 1.23 lakh crores and provisions of Rs 0.53 lakh crores to the government. Why was this important? Two reasons. Reason one, high NPAs in both the banking and non-banking financial institutions, coupled with deep mistrust among players, had led to a liquidity crisis in the country, leading to shrinking of key industrial and infrastructure sectors and slowdown of economy. The surplus fund transfer of Rs 1.76 lakh crore, that's approximately 1% of the GDP, will help government to increase public investments that is pegged at Rs 8.8 lakh crores for FY20, recapitalize banks and provide a much needed stimulus to the economy. Reason 2. GST collections in June has fallen below Rs 1 lakh crores. It is estimated that government needs a GST velocity of over Rs 1 lakh crores to be able to meet its fiscal targets and not compensate states for GST losses. A portion of the excess cash from RBI can well support government to maintain its fiscal targets. Now the question becomes, are there any potential pitfalls to this decision? Undoubtedly, there are both proponents and opponents of this philosophy. On one hand, proponents of the move suggest that in such dire circumstances, idle cash in the coffers of RBI beyond the required limit to manage risk is unproductive for the economy. RBI, as discovered in the Jalan Committee report, is one of the highly capitalized central banks in the world. Transmission of this idle cash into economic use can boost the economy. It would also allow government reforms to have a wider impact in kickstarting the credit and capex cycle. It is already a well-established process in developed markets, such as the US, where central bank transferred US$19 billion to the government. On the other hand, opponents to the policy believe that the excess funds transferred from RBI to meet the fiscal deficit is not a prudent practice. One, government will end up utilizing the funds to meet its revenue deficits. Even experts such as Arvind Subramaniam, supporting the transfer reserves, agree that the funds should be utilized in capital schemes, that is balance sheet firms, and not expenditures or PLN items. Two, it should be the prerogative of the RBI to ascertain the levels of capital risk it wants to keep on its balance sheet. RBI has been able to exhibit exceptional performance compared to other central banks around the world because of the autonomy it had till now. Interference from government in these policy matters is a bad precedent. Only time will tell if the opponents or the proponents were correct in their assessment, but for now, it surely is a historic and bold move by the RBI.